thank you all for coming out. I know it's kind of a real time spot after lunch. It's usually the spot all speakers date, so don't worry about that. I am Dave Stokes. I'm the Lab of Community Manager for Oracle, which means the KV program and Agile and Lab of Product. Part of the presentation I do, if you ask a good question, I'll send you one of these or one of these. I like interaction with my presentation. If you want a copy of these slides, I do recommend you get them because there's a lot of data on these slides. I have 77 slides in 50 minutes, so I'm going to skip over a lot of the smaller text. So go to slideshare.net/DavidMStokes and download it. Maybe later, and I'll sell you a copy. So, MySQL 5.7 came out last fall. Very impressive amount of changes in there. We did over 150 changes. One of the biggest ones for interested programmers is a native JSON data type. Before 5.7, if you were going to store JSON in a MySQL database, you put it in a text column or some short sort. Worked, not very sexy, not a bunch of stuff in there. And MongoDB. So we now have a native JSON data type. For those of you who have been in a hole for the past couple years, don't know what JSON is, and it's for JavaScript object notation. It's not limited only to JavaScript. Complicated a lot of stuff. I'm sure you've been playing with configuration files written in JSON. So don't confuse it with this. Stuff. This is where Ray Harry Hobbins is. You're probably going to wonder how real life meets Hollywood across the desert to be a sword, but Hollywood, or the British version of Hollywood. Popped up on third class movies from time to time. If you've never seen it, it's worth a whole lot. So, what does JSON look like? Well, basically, you have a key and a value. In this case, the first key is ID and the value is blank. Very simple. How does the native JSON data type work for Linux as well? We got a warning here before we get into this. There's always more than one way to scan the cap. The addendum to that was how we scan the cap that we really need. So in the past, you do something like this. You create a text column and shove in your JSON. It works. It's not great. There's no easy way to take the data out of that column. You're breaking the first rule. Basically, you can break up data into small parts, hoping that you put in relational models and you can key off other items. Also, doing this way, it's going to be slow. More than likely, you're going to end up with a full table scan. And for a lot of you, that means you're going to end up writing some regex code, which most programmers do not know. So, 5.7, we have an optimized way to store your JSON data. When you go throw the data into the column, the first thing it does is it makes sure it's a valid JSON document. You can't store junk in there. It's going to optimize it in binary format. It's going to sort things, and there's some caveats to that. The binary formats, so the server can go out and grab the stuff in the most effective way it can. The big problem that you're going to run into for some of you is the size of your JSON documents. Right now, the max you can have is max allowed packet size. This is very, whatever that is, probably at least a gigabyte or 2 gigabytes. Now, if you set this on the server and it's default, it's good. If you set it on a session, the server's going to ignore it. So be careful with this. Now, JSON columns cannot have default value. They also cannot be indexed. I'll show you the workaround on that. So, what do you do to use it? Create a table. You have a column type as JSON. And you're calling it JDoc. Just type JSON. And I insert the value in the code. And when you pull it out, that's what it looks like. So if you're dealing with JSON in some other database like Postgres or a SQL server, it works basically the same way. Now, some of you who are from the old school are going to wonder, well, how much is the bar char or char column going to cost? Well, it's roughly 4.5% more here. We're trying to shrink this down, but we weren't there for the whole thing. Something else that happens is that, this gentleman brought up, as you put in the data, if you're reusing keys, it's going to take the first instance of that key. In this one, you can see here that we're inputting key one, key two, and key one again. So it's only going to keep the first instance of key one. Also, when we put it in the binary format for the server, we also sort the key. Now, by the way, the JSON standard is, the list is not supposed to matter, but if you pull stuff out, it may not go in the same key.
Is there a standard for
searching. Once we're modifying data, data wants to return information about the attributes of the information. Like how deep the document is, the length, the length, whether it's actually valid. The next series of slides, a lot of detail, especially for you folks in the back, you're probably not going to be able to see this, because it's down to the copy of the slides. The functions work like you would expect. Here's what we're getting a JSON, we're creating a JSON array, and I'm going to put the information, then we have another one for cycling it. Functions of search, JSON underscore contains. By the way, if you go back to the old documents that we have in this first release, all the functions start with JSN underscore. And we sat down in discussion saying, you know, we should probably put JSON underscore because JSN might be confusing. So if you're reading the old blog post on this, you see JSN instead of JSON. Search. Here's a way where you return the keys. So if you're looking for a particular key in a document, there, by the way, document equals column contents. So here's a way to search multiple columns. Set, insert, place are all related. They're probably going to be the most complementary we use for manipulating data. You can also uncode stuff, like stuff in the JSON document, manualize your controls, do that. We also have a list of the escape sequences in here. So if you need to put in a form feed or a new line or a carriage return, depth of the document. So like version 1 of your document has data, version 2 has 10. You can quickly run this on a column and find out which version of the document you have. I can also get the entire document. Now, by default, all the JSON that we're doing is the character set UTF-MB4. Now, I normally advise people or other little character things taking on standards, ABCD, type information. Stay lat. If you can't do that, go to UTF-MB4, not UTF-MB8, or UTF-8, but full UTF-MB4. Now, save a lot of hassle for our developers. valid data, it'll be rejected by the server. If not a SQL mode, switch to turn that off, you'll be able to put in bad stuff. Now, cast and hex, is also something that's set for this link. And, once again, the dollar sign is the analog of this. So if you're running your functions, think of this, the last code, JSON, the dollar sign. If you're doing a dot star, it's gonna be all the members of the object. And then you can actually go through the various cells of the object. Also, we all got that, I can give you the quiz, and all your tasks, right? One reason I put all the information in here is hopefully if you're gonna play with this, go back, download this, and see this here. If you have any questions, refer to that, otherwise go back. So, what do you have in PHP for JSON functions? Well, there's not a whole bunch of them. JSON decodes a JSON string, encodes, so you have the gang there. Awaiting the last error message, and the last error. So here's a simple PHP program, takes some data, JSON encoded. Works great with PHP, don't use that for MySQL, use the MySQL function. So. Now here's a simple program that's gonna go out and do a query with a JSON call. If you've ever queried a MySQL database before, this all looks very similar to you, and it's gonna give you back basically the same information. That makes a lot of sense. Now, here's a little more complex example. I'm inserting into a simple table, a JSON array, and you see the arguments of the array. I'd rather use the MySQL functions. They're designed to work with the database. I've had some problems with the JSON underscore encode from PHP. This way I know it works. The other way, it works about 70% of the time.
Is that maybe because it's too
It could be. I have a feeling it's a different interpretation of the standard support. The MySQL database is going to shove everything into UTF-8 before. Okay. Remember that to store the JSON information and column for breaking one big problem in the database, which is where you cut the data into the smallest usable part. Well, you break that, it means a lot of SQL support for the column goes away. You can't index the JSON column. It's nasty to find itself go through and try to track the standard SQL code, so that's why we have functions. So our engineers gave us something called generated columns. There's two types. Virtual doesn't store anything out there, but you say, okay, this column is a combination of this column times this column. And when it gets read, I'll take those two columns, do the multiplication, and return that with the data. There's another type called stored, which is not the column. What stored does is it materializes that information. That's TVA speak for saying, you tell it that it's taking this column and doing some function, putting a value in there, it's going to store it out there. So there is storage space out there for that. Multiple types should have no restrictions. Stuff, but only generated columns can store generated columns. apartment. For those of you who don't know the database enough, an index will show you right to the particular record you want. If it's not indexed, the database has to read the entire file data, which is very inefficient and runs very, very slowly. So, here's a simple example. We're going to create a table called T1. We're going to have a column, an integer column called F1, an integer column called GC. Checking with him ever since, and it hasn't created, so request to JSON, he wants to work that way, yeah. My neighbor used to write his API request all in XML. That's a good way to do that. Yes, sir.
Looks like Dr. Norm's been working with building the JSON objects, our database system seems to have JSON. We've been working with Dr. Norm on that to try to encourage use in more and more other reports using the JSON.
I don't know if our engineers have been working with Dr. folks to cover all this. Usually the other way around, they start trying to find things, let us know if there's something broken that we need to fix. I know Brian O'Rourke is planning to break now and having a trouble. It's just another column, like an inch or a char that shouldn't have any problems, but. Until you get 10,000 people counting, I don't know really what.
I guess that's what I was kind of asking, is how many, you know, how many more are looking to work in the process? That sounds like a lot.
Yeah, we can't mention because I'm an MBA.
Okay.
Explain right now. Yes, sir.
You mentioned for a stored column that, is it, it's actually putting in more data than, it's got to actually save that on the disk. So they can then do an index also as well on that?
That's the way it's eventually going to be. First, it's going to throw it into memory, and then the server will flush it out the disk. But if you are using generated columns, generated column is stored, we'll put it out on disk. So I'm old school, I used to have to worry about everything. I had to wait for sector rotational latency. In the old days, we had to do that sort of stuff. Right now, you can buy about a terabyte drive at your local hardware store for a few hundred bucks, if not on sale. But that should be an issue very
quickly. Is that your Instagram?
I haven't seen the slide deck. Do you have an example or?
Yeah, I'll get your copy down here. I have to go thank you for Fletcher.
Oh, okay.
Like the exception. Yeah, basically. 5.7.
And then you see this, the is now the
error notation. It's the dollar sign of dollar notation. Search out the JSON.
So what's the name? Well, you might have something that you're pulling off from some other source, and you want to make sure to sell JSON document before you go to use it for production for the overhead setting of the connection of the database and push it in there.
Is the PHP encode function like sufficient? If I can get it to go through there without an error, is that good enough to get any, you know, column muscles of JSON columns?
The PHP JSON encode, yes. My testing, which is extensive, probably about 8 hours from testing over the past 2 weeks. 70% of the time, yes. The other 30% of the time. If you have any other questions, catch me afterwards. I'll be downstairs for the rest of the day. My email address is there. I'm always on Twitter. It's fairly easy to track down. For those of you going to Scale Conference next week in LA, I'll be there. For those of you going to FOSDEM the week after that, I'll be there. There's a lot of conferences, so thank you all for coming out.